learn to calculate the average velocity, correct? And we are going to learn the average speed, correct? For both uniform and non-uniform motion. Fine, so we will not going to start any new topic. These are the all the topic was just today what we are going to do. We are going to do calculation, fine? So yesterday, actually we had the your formula for the acceleration, that is A is equal to delta V upon T. So where delta V is change in velocity. Now how we calculate this change? We can calculate the change by subtracting final velocity to initial velocity. Fine. I also explained that acceleration is positive when speed is increasing, and acceleration is negative when speed is decreasing. We had also unit of the acceleration, as we discussed earlier, that was the meter per second. So let us take one simple example. So we can calculate, we are going to calculate the acceleration. Let's say a car is moving with the speed, is having the speed 72 km per hour, and the velocity increases to 108 km per hour in 10 seconds. What will be the acceleration of this car? This is the question. Fine. So this is the question. The car is already moving with 72 km per hour, and its speed is increasing in 10 seconds up to 108 km per hour. So in that case, we have to calculate the acceleration. What you didn't understand, Binal and Sivendu? Please mention the particular. I am explaining so many things. Which one you didn't understand? How do you know which topic you didn't understand? And I already said in the class that whatever doubt you get, just please write down in somewhere in your notebook. And end of the class, when I ask if you have any doubt, you can ask them. If you keep raising your hand in between, if you keep asking such question in between, then our class is going to be disturbed. So please don't do that. If you have any doubt, please write down somewhere in your notebook. And end of the class, we will discuss your doubt. Fine. So 72 km per hour. So here, this is your initial velocity. We denote it with U, that is your initial velocity. And this is your final velocity. We denote it with V. Fine. And this is the time, we write down it as T. Fine. So first of all, this U is 72 km per hour. So first of all, we have to convert into meter per second. And I explained the method that how you multiply. You have to multiply it 1000 and divided by 3600 to convert it into meter per second. So this 00 will be gone, and I think 18 36 2s are is 72. So it will be 20 meter per second. Now V is what? That is 108 kilometer per hour. So we are going to multiply 108 multiply by 1000 divided by 3600 meter per second. Fine. So what will be the answer? This will be 0 and 0 will be cut. 36 threes up is 108. This means 30 meter per second. So this is how we calculated the initial velocity and final velocity. So yes,
So if you now substitute in acceleration, acceleration is what? Change in velocity, that is delta v upon t. So delta v is final velocity minus initial velocity upon time. So final velocity is 30, initial velocity is 20, and divided by time is 10. Am I doing right or wrong? Is it correct? 30 minus 20 divided by 10, that is 10 upon 10, that is 1 meter per second squared. Fine, that is 1 meter per second square. Aditya, better you sit down on a table and then join the meeting. How many of you got correct answer? Which part of the calculation you didn't understand? If you don't understand the whole, you haven't attended the class. If you keep your phone aside meanwhile and go somewhere else and then come again and say, sir, I didn't understand, how it is going to be possible? Nothing difficult in this calculation. This is the easiest one. And if you are not able to understand this one, it means you are not attending the class properly. You are not totally focused in the class. Your mind is somewhere else. Fine. So this is one question. Let us take another question so we can understand it more clearly. We can do more of such questions. So example number two, let's say a car is moving with 50 meter per second, applies the brakes. And its speed reduced to 30 meter per second in half minute. Calculate acceleration. Fine, this is the question. And give me the answer. This is very easy one. The car is moving with the speed 50 meter per second, applies the brakes, and its speed reduces to 30 meter per second in half minute. It means the car is here having the speed 50 meter per second. It is moving somewhere at some different point, it is having the speed 30 meter per second, and it takes half minute. Half minute, it means 1/2, and for minute we take 60 seconds, so it is taking 30 seconds. Fine. So you have to just identify final velocity, initial velocity, and then substitute in the value. So final velocity, that is the last velocity. So initially, if you see the question, it was earlier having the 50 meter per second before applying the brake, that is the initial speed. And after applying the brake, it becomes the 30 meter per second. So your final velocity here is, that is V, is 30 meter per second and your initial velocity u is 50 meter per second and the time for which it is traveling is half, that is 30 seconds, that is half minute, correct? Now you can use this formula, a is equal to, that is delta v upon t, that is v minus u by t. So v minus u is, v is 30, u is 50 divided by 30. So that will be the 20 divided by 30, it is minus 2 by 3 meter per second. Fine, this is how you calculate the acceleration. Minus 2 by 3 meter per second, correct. Here negative sign indicate that the speed of object is decreasing, correct. Fine, meter per second square. The last question you should try by yourself, write down. Example 3. Let's say a train starting from rest takes 2 minutes to achieve speed of 108 kilometer per hour speed, then find acceleration of train. Come on, do it. A train starting from rest takes 2 minutes to achieve the speed of 108 kilometer per hour. Find the acceleration of the train. Yes, Dipan, acceleration can be negative also, it can be positive, it can be zero. Come on, calculate everyone. A train starting from rest takes 2 minutes to achieve the speed of 108 kilometer per hour. Find the acceleration of the train. So it is starting from rest, correct? Starting from rest. So initial speed, because it is at rest, we can write down the initial speed u. U is equal to zero. Why we are taking u is equal to zero? Starting from rest. Correct? Starting from rest. Now v, that is the final velocity. So final velocity is this one, that is 108 kilometer per hour. 108 kilometer per hour. We have to convert into meter per second. So what is the procedure? We will multiply 108 with 1000 and divided by it 3600. So speed of final speed of the train is going to be 30 meter per second. If you do the calculation, 0,0 will cut out and this will be 330 meters per second. Now, as you know, formula, the time is given 2 minutes. So, 2 into 60. So, it is going to be 120 seconds. Now, acceleration A is equal to V minus U upon T. So, V is 30, U is 0, T is 120. That is 30 upon 120, that is 1 by 4 meter per second square. Correct? Yes, 0.25. Fine. So last question of calculating acceleration is this one. Write down. Everyone will write down the question. Please write down the question and tell me the answer. A car moving with the speed of 96 km per hour a car is moving with speed of 96 kilometer per hour takes 30 seconds to stop 30 seconds to stop. Find acceleration. Come on, do the calculation. Yes, acceleration can be zero when speed of the car is not changing. Velocity of the car is not changing. Then acceleration will be zero. If you have done the homework, Khyati, you would haven't have this doubt. Please do the calculation and tell me the answer. Car is moving with the speed 96 km per hour. It takes 30 seconds to stop. Find acceleration. Those who will not give the answer of this question in the chat box, they will be marked as an absent. Those who are having the doubt, please write down your doubt and at the end of the class, please ask. Okay, fine. Most of them you are getting correct answer, that is 0.8 minus 0.8 meter per second. So now you are clear with how to calculate the acceleration. So we can start our next discussion, that is calculating average speed. Fine. Why we are calculating the average speed? So that for entire motion, we don't have to tell the different speed. For example, let's say a car is moving from one point A to one point another point B. So somewhere speed might be changing. Somewhere it have higher speed, for example 60 km per hour. Somewhere it will have might 80 km per hour. Somewhere again reduces 40 km per hour. It means it is performing non-uniform motion. In that case, at every point, it has different speed. So if I ask what speed the car is moving between A to B, whether it is 60 km per hour, whether it is 80 km per hour, whether it is 40 km per hour, we cannot have one speed. We cannot tell one speed. Correct? Because at every point, the speed of car is different. So in that case, we generalize one speed. What we do, we generalize, we say only one speed which include all the speed. That is called the average speed of the object. Correct? Average speed of the object. For an example, if your car is moving with certain speed, let's say 40 meter per second. Correct? And after certain time, the speed becomes 60 meter per second. And if I ask you question, with what speed car is moving? Because it is continuously increasing, correct? it is now 40 meter per second, then it will become 45, then it will become 55, then it 50, then it becomes 55, then it become finally 60. Or like it has all the numbers. And if I ask you what is the speed of this car, what your answer will be? Because there are so many different speed. Because starting speed is 40 meter per second, that is you, and final speed is 60 meter per second. So at what speed the car is moving? In that case, we calculate the average. Correct? So how do we calculate the average? So calculating the average speed, this is the symbol of the average speed, correct? A V, and you have to draw bracket like this. Or if you don't want to write like this, you can write like V average. So that will be the initial velocity plus final velocity divided by 2. Correct? Fine. So it will be 40 plus 60 divided by 2. So that means 50 meter per second. So we can say this car is moving with the average speed of 50 meter per second. In earlier case, you were confused that at what speed this car is actually moving. Now you can say this car is moving with the average velocity of 50 meter per second. So why we need average? So because if we have different kind of a speed, we can have the idea of the speed of the car with one single speed only. Correct? Now there are two methods of calculating the average speed. Correct? One is this one, which I already explained. Correct? This one. That is average speed is the average, actual average, that is V plus U by 2. Now another method of calculating V average is equal to V average is equal to total distance covered by object, covered, divided by total time. I will tell you when to use this formula and when to use this formula both. So these are both formula for calculating average speed. Fine. So let me just give you when we will use which formula. If in the question, if it is it is mentioned that speed is changing uniformly. Correct? If this word is mentioned in anywhere, if uniformly or uniform motion, moving with uniform motion, anywhere uniform word is mentioned, then you use this formula. This one. Correct? So you can use this formula wherever the uniform is mentioned. And whenever their uniform is not mentioned, in all the other question where uniform is not mentioned, you can use this formula, that is V average is equal to total distance upon total. Correct? So let us take one example. Fine. Like generally what happens in this case, the speed of the particle is in parts. Small parts. Correct? Fine. So let us take the example. Example, a car is moving with speed 20 kilometer per hour for 2 hours and 30 kilometer per hour for next 4 hours. What is average speed of car? Correct? This is the question. A car is moving with the speed 20 km per hour for 2 hours and 30 km per hour for next 4 hours. What is the average speed of the car? थोड़ा क्वेश्चन समझने की कोशिश करते हैं. पहले कार यहाँ से स्टार्ट करती है 2 hours के लिए ट्रैवल करती है. सो दिस इज 20 किलोमीटर पर आवर और वो कितने टाइम के लिए है, 2 आवर्स के लिए. फिर नेक्स्ट 4 आवर्स के लिए वो ट्रैवल करती है, 4 आवर्स के लिए विद द स्पीड 30 किलोमीटर पर आवर. करेक्ट. तो नाम दे देते, दिस इज ए बी एंड सी, मतलब ए और बी के बीच में 2 आवर्स के लिए वो 20 किलोमीटर पर आवर की स्पीड से जा रही है, एंड बिटवीन बी टू सी 30 किलोमीटर पर आवर जा रही है. अब इस क्वेश्चन में कहीं पे भी यूनिफॉर्म वर्ड यूज किया है, करेक्ट, यूनिफॉर्म वर्ड यूज नहीं किया है तो ये फॉर्मूला हम यूज नहीं करेंगे. और आप देखो तो यहाँ पे मोशन कैसी है सेगमेंट में, पहले पार्ट ए बी है फिर पार्ट बी सी है. सो ये जो सेकेंड वाला फॉर्मूला, ये पार्ट्स वाली फॉर्मूला, मतलब हमको ये फॉर्मूला यूज करनी है, दैट इज टोटल डिस्टेंस कवर्ड बाय द, दिस डिवाइडेड बाय टोटल टाइम. नाउ हाउ वी कैलकुलेट टोटल डिस्टेंस, टोटल डिस्टेंस कितना हो जाएगा आप बता सकते हो? टोटल डिस्टेंस विल बी व्हाट? टोटल डिस्टेंस विल बी ए बी प्लस बी सी, दैट इज टोटल डिस्टेंस कवर्ड बाय द कार, करेक्ट. एंड टोटल टाइम कितना हो जाएगा? टोटल टाइम फर्स्ट कितने आवर के लिए मूव करिए, 2 आवर के लिए, फिर कितने आवर के लिए, 4 आवर के लिए, तो टोटल टाइम हो गया 6 आवर. इसमें तो कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं, बट हमको टोटल डिस्टेंस निकालना पड़ेगा. अब टोटल डिस्टेंस कैसे निकालेंगे, तो आपको स्पीड पता है क्या होती है, स्पीड क्या होती है, डिस्टेंस अपॉन टाइम. तो इस फॉर्मूला को अगर आप क्रॉस मल्टीप्लीकेशन करोगे तो डिस्टेंस विल बी स्पीड मल्टीप्लाई विथ टाइम, करेक्ट. तो आपको डिस्टेंस ए बी कैलकुलेट करना है. अब ए बी कैलकुलेट करना है, सो व्हाट विल बी, व्हाट इज द स्पीड बिटवीन द ए बी, दैट इज 20 किलोमीटर पर आवर. सो यू हैव टू सब्स्टिट्यूट 20 किलोमीटर पर आवर, करेक्ट, मल्टीप्लाई बाय द टाइम. व्हाट इज द टाइम हियर? दैट इज 2 आवर्स. Correct. If you multiply this, R, R will cut, and 2 into 2, 40. That is 40 kilometer. So AB is 40 kilometer. In similar manner, we can calculate BC. So next part or next segment is BC. Correct. So what we will do? We will multiply the speed. This is 30 kilometer per hour. And time for which it is traveling, it is 4 hours. Correct. So this RR again will cut, and 330 multiplied by 4, that is 120 kilometer. So your total distance, as I mentioned earlier, that is AB plus BC. So it is going to be 40 plus 120, that makes it 160 kilometer. Fine. So we have calculated total distance 160. Total time 6 hours. So we can now calculate the average speed. V average is equal to total distance. Okay, total distance upon total time. So total distance is 160 kilometer, and time is 6 hours. Fine. So if you do the calculation, I think it will go with 3. 160 divided by 6. 6 2s are. नहीं जाएगा ना, फ्रैक्शन में आंसर आएगा. सो इट विल बी 80 डिवाइडेड बाय 3 किलोमीटर पर आवर. सो दिस इज योर एवरेज बैलेंस. फाइन. सो दिस इज हाउ यू कैलकुलेट द एवरेज वेलोसिटी. इज इट क्लियर टू एवरीवन? हाउ डू वी कैलकुलेट एवरेज वेलोसिटी? Okay, let me give you another question so we can get clear idea. A bicycle is moving with 10 meter per second speed for 2 minutes, then 15 meter per second for next 5 minutes, and then 8 meters per second for next 1 minute. Find average speed of bicycle. Come on, do the calculation. Come on, very easy. Bicycle is moving, so आपके यहाँ पे कितने पॉइंट आएंगे? पहले ये सेगमेंट आएगा, दो सेगमेंट और तीन सेगमेंट. पहले A to B, B to C और C to D. A to B में स्पीड कितना है? 10 मीटर पर सेकेंड और वहाँ पे टाइम है 2 मिनट. फिर B to C में कितना स्पीड है? 15 मीटर पर सेकेंड और वहाँ पे टाइम है 5 मिनट. एंड देन स्पीड है 8 मीटर पर सेकेंड और वहाँ पे टाइम है 1 मिनट. कम ऑन, डू द कैलकुलेशन एवरीवन एंड टेल मी द आंसर. माइंड यू डू द कैलकुलेशन इन मीटर पर सेकेंड ओनली. सो कन्वर्ट टाइम इन सेकेंड एंड देन और जस्ट रिमेन इन द मीटर पर सेकेंड ओनली. गेट योर आंसर, फाइनल आंसर ऑफ एवरेज स्पीड इन मीटर पर मिनट ओनली. सो डू नॉट डू कन्वर्जन. Final answer should be in meter per minute. Four, one, two meter per second. My God. Okay. So many different answer. I think you have making mistake in some students are doing the conversion, some are not doing the conversion, some of are doing half of the conversion. If you want to do calculation in meter per second, then it's also okay, fine. So if you want to do with meter per second, you can do meter per second, your choice. Fine. So how many segments are there? 3. So which formula we are going to use, first one or second one? Because there is no mention of uniform, correct? There is no mention of uniform and the motion is in segments. So in that case, we are going to use this total distance upon total time formula. So first of all, we will calculate distance AB. How we calculate distance AB? That is speed multiplied by the time. Speed is 10 meter per second and time is 2 minutes. Now if you convert 2 minutes in second, that is 2 into 60 seconds. So it will be 1200 meter. Am I correct? First AB is correct or not? Please tell me, have I got AB correct? Similar manner you will calculate BC, that is V into T again. So V is what? 15 meter per second multiplied by 5. 5 minute is 5 into 60 second. Correct. So what will be the answer? Can you give me the calculation of this answer? What is the answer of this one? That is 15 into 5 into 60. Please do the calculation and tell me. Please, some of the students do the calculation and tell me. 4500. Meter. Fine. Now last part is CD. So how do you calculate CD? That is V into T. So V is 8 meter per second and 1 and for second a minute we are going to put 60. So this is 480 meter. Now the total distance will be 1200 plus 4500 plus 480. What is the answer of this one? What is the total? 6180 meter. Is it correct? Okay, fine. And total time will be first is 2 minute, then it is 5 minute plus 1 minute. So the total time will be 8 minute. Now if you want to use as a minute, you can just substitute the value, correct? That is 1680 divided by 8. If you do this, you will, that will be your answer in meter per minute. If you want to calculate in meter per minute, we average, so that will be 6180 divided by 8. So whatever answer you will get, something in meter per minute. You can do the calculation division by your own. But if you want to convert it into second, it's okay. So you can multiply 8 with 60, that is 480 second. Fine. So V average will be 6180 divided by 480. That will be your answer in meter per second. Is it clear to everyone? 772 meter, 0.5. It's no. It must be a less number. Let me just do on the calculator. Six one eight zero divided by 480. That is 12.87 meter per second. This is the answer I'm getting.